Oh. Is that your food?
No, no, Gregor. It's a 22 Beretta aimed at your nuts. Now, if you're careless enough to lose your wallet, you sure can't be trusted with all that uranium on a crowded train.
What are you, CIA? MI6.
Oh, come on, Greg. Do I look like a woman that plays for the minor leagues?
Your Citadel.
Citadel is a new series on Amazon Prime Video about agents Mason Kane and Nadia Sin, two top Citadel spies who are set up and, after a train accident, have their memories erased. 8 years later, Manticore, the powerful criminal syndicate behind the train accident, finds out the two agents are still alive. Now, Mason and Nadia need to reunite forces, get their memories back, and stop Manticore. Let's learn some English today with this action-packed series. But in case you're new here, our method is really simple. First, you will watch the scenes with subtitles. Then we'll teach you some of the most important vocabulary, grammar, and pronunciation from the clips. Finally, you will test your listening skills by watching the scenes again without subtitles. But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell down below, because every week we put out a new lesson like this to help you understand your favorite movies and TV series without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. So hit the subscribe button in order not to miss one single new lesson.
Manticore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world, who built their own spy network to manipulate world events and amass wealth and power. And with Citadel slaughtered and MindTech in their hands, they wreaked havoc. Early this morning, Citadel's X case containing all our secrets was stolen by 2 Manticore agents. The kind of secrets that could murder millions of people or hold entire nations hostage. So I need you to come to New York with me and get that case before Manticore can open it. I need Mason Kane.
I'm not him. The f*** is wrong with you?
There's my guy. Your mind may not remember, but your body does. I mean, you were our top spy, after all.
I was Citadel's top spy?
Well, no, not really the top spy. I mean, you did have a partner. I mean, alone, you two were, you know, you were amazing. But together, you were hot stuff.
What was her name?
Her name was Nadia Singh. You helped me get that case. I'll help you remember who you were and who she was. Manticore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world.
To be wealthy means to be rich, to have a lot of money. Here we can see the word being used in the superlative form, the wealthiest. Whenever you have an adjective that ends in Y like this, for example, wealthy, the superlative form goes wealthiest. It's a E-ist at the end. We drop the Y and we add I-E-S-T. Other examples could be happy, the happiest, busy, the busiest, and funny, the funniest. Here's a clip.
You know the funniest part of this? You still think we're making you a superhero.
So again, the word funniest means most funny. Got it?
Manticore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world, who built their own spy network to manipulate world events and amass wealth and power.
Okay, wealthy is the adjective, as I just explained. A wealthy family, for example. Wealth is the noun. Wealth means fortune, material prosperity, lots of money. And the verb to amass means to accumulate. So in this case, to amass wealth and power means to accumulate wealth and power. Here's an example from one of the X-Men movies.
And whenever he was close to death, he would just take on a new body. Some of these may have been the bodies of mutants, enabling him to take their powers, amassing various abilities over the years.
An all-powerful mutant.
Exactly.
So in this situation, we can see that the character is amassing or accumulating, collecting superpowers over the years.
Manticore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world, who built their own spy network to manipulate world events and amass wealth and power. And with Citadel slaughtered and MindTech in their hands, they wreaked havoc.
We have 2 possible meanings for the verb to slaughter. To slaughter means to kill animals for food. This is one meaning. Another meaning is to kill people or animals brutally, with cruelty, just for the sake of killing. This is actually the way this word is being used in this context. The Citadel agents were slaughtered in the past. They were killed brutally. This word is very common in action and epic movies and series. Here's an example.
We've been fighting them for thousands of years. They've slaughtered villages. They've slaughtered our brothers. And we slaughtered theirs.
And with Citadel slaughtered and MindTech in their hands, they wreaked havoc.
To wreak havoc means to cause great damage. What's interesting is that these 2 words individually, they mean similar things. Wreak means to cause damage or harm, while havoc means confusion, destruction. So to wreak havoc, to cause great damage.
I'm here live on Park Avenue at 56th Street, where it is complete chaos. A man in some sort of weaponized armored suit is wreaking havoc on Midtown.
Early this morning, Citadel's X case containing all our secrets was stolen by 2 Manticore agents.
Here's a fun fact for you. Did you know that Manticore is a Greek mythological figure? He has the face of a man, the body of a lion, and the tail of a dragon or scorpion. But it's also important to point out the pronunciation of Manticore. Notice that there is an NT in the word. Whenever you have this combination, N and T, there is a tendency, especially in American English, for us to drop the T and pronounce the N before. So if you listen closely, the actor says Manticore, Manticore, instead of Manticore. Other examples could be international, international, instead of international, and sentimental, sentimental, instead of sentimental. Here's an example.
Are you gonna tell me what's so important about this rock or what?
I told you, it's just something I want. Sentimental value.
Early this morning, Citadel's X case containing all our secrets was stolen by 2 Manticore agents. The kind of secrets that could murder millions of people or hold entire nations hostage.
To hold someone hostage means to keep someone as a prisoner without their permission or consent. The hostage is the person being held captive. Another great word for you to learn in this context is ransom. Usually the criminals responsible for keeping the person captive ask for a ransom. The ransom is a sum of money that is asked in exchange for the person who has been taken.
I told him not to pay the ransom. I thought we had time on our side.
You used the girl as bait.
Yes.
The money in King's briefcase was precisely the same amount as the ransom demand for his daughter.
So I need you to come to New York with me and get that case before Manticore can open it.
Nice connected speech here. First of all, we have need and you. D for need and Y for you. This combination, D plus Y, usually sounds like Jew. Jew. So we hear, I need you. I need you. Then the preposition to sounds like a R. So the O is a schwa sound, a, and the T is a flap T, R. I need you, R. I need you, R. So here we hear, I need you to come. I need you to come.
So I need you to come to New York with me. Your mind may not remember, but your body does.
More connected speech. T for butt. Y for your. This combination, T plus Y, sounds like ch, ch. So we hear butcher, butcher, but sure. Also, your tends to be reduced in speech as well. Your becomes your. So we hear butcher, but your body does, but your body does.
But your body does. I mean, alone, you two were, you know, you were amazing, but together you were hot stuff.
If you call somebody hot stuff, you mean that person is very skillful or talented. Another meaning also for hot stuff means someone who's very sexually attractive. Keep in mind that in both cases here, this is an informal term, hot stuff. Here's an example with a second meaning that is more sexually related. Here it is.
Hey.
Hey, hot stuff.
Me? Hello.
Damn, this neighborhood's sweet.
Isn't it frustrating when you learn a new word and when it's time to actually speak English with someone, you completely forget it? Now, I find that the best solution for this is, whenever you learn a new word, to use it as soon as possible in conversation. But what happens when you don't have somebody to practice speaking English with? Well, that's exactly why we created the Real Life app, which is the only place where anytime, anywhere, you can press a button and instantly connect to another English speaker in another part of the world to have a conversation and speak together, and maybe even practice all these new expressions that you're learning in today's lesson. And on the app, you can also listen to the Real Life English podcast lessons with Ethan and myself. And we give you transcripts and vocabulary flashcards to help you understand and learn more with each new episode. So if you want to go from feeling like a lost, insecure English learner to becoming a confident, natural English speaker, make sure you download the Real Life English app. I'm going to leave the link to the app right here in the description of this video, or you can also go to Google Play Store, Apple App Store, search for Real Life English and download the app from there. I'm sure you're gonna love it. Now let's get back to the lesson.
Bernard Orlick, Manticore, the X case. Any of that ring a bell?
You really need to get out of my way, buddy.
They wiped your memories. I was in a train 8 years ago in Italy. There was an explosion. I was pulled from the water. I couldn't remember who I was or how I got there. You were on that train with me.
No.
You were a spy, like me, for an organization called Citadel.
I don't know what you're on, but I'm gonna walk past you through that door, and if you touch me, I'm gonna scream, okay?
Catch.
Did you just throw a knife at me?
I thought you were gonna catch it. See, Bernard did it to me, and I thought you were gonna catch it, and then I was gonna be like, then how come you can do that?
Hey, you better back up.
I'm sorry, that
you
is my bad.
Up.
I am backing up.
That's not backing up.
I'm backed
that's
up.
Back up!
Not to your thing.
Tier 1 operator. Identified.
Right.
That's
you. Bernard Orlick, Manticore, the X case. Any of that ring a bell?
You really need to get out of my way, buddy.
When Mason asks, any of that ring a bell? He's asking, do you remember? You know what I'm talking about? Does any of that sound familiar? That's what he's asking. The full version here would be, does any of that ring a bell? When something rings a bell, it makes you remember of something else. It sounds familiar. Also notice that he doesn't pronounce the does, but he simply says, any of that ring a bell? This is actually very common in everyday speech. Especially native speakers tend to do this. They tend to drop the auxiliary verb in order to sound more casual and natural. Here are some examples. Did you see the movie yesterday? To, you see the movie yesterday? Are you hungry? To, you hungry?
The X case. Any of that ring a bell?
You really need to get out of my way, buddy.
They wiped your memories.
More nice connected speech here. First of all, need to. Notice the D for need is dropped. Need to. And then get out. The T for get becomes a flap T. Ra, ra, ra. Get out. And then of is reduced to a schwa sound, So putting it all together, we have get outa, get outa.
You really need to get out of my way, buddy. You really need to get out of my way, buddy.
They wiped your memories. I was on a train.
To wipe, in this context, means to remove or eliminate completely. In this case, they wiped your memories. They eliminated your memories. They erased them. There's also a very common phrasal verb, which is wipe out. To wipe out means to destroy something or a group of people completely. Here's an example.
I have your approval to proceed then, my lord.
Wipe them out. All of them.
They wiped your memories. I was on a train 8 years ago in Italy. There was an explosion. I was pulled from the water.
Which image shows someone being pulled from the water? Remember not to confuse the words push and pull, all right? Pull is this movement, okay? You pull something to you, pull. While push is the opposite direction. You move it away from you, push.
I don't know what you're on, but I'm gonna walk past you through that door, and if you touch me, I'm gonna scream, okay?
Catch.
I don't know what you're on. This is the same as saying, I don't know what you're saying. I don't know what you're talking about, all right? But this actually reminds me of another common question that we have in informal situations, which goes, are you on something? This means, are you high? In the sense of, did you take any drugs or are you under the influence of something? Because what you're saying doesn't make any sense. Are you on something?
How are we gonna do that?
We start by finding out what Jenna knows.
Are you on something?
Jenna's at the top of our A-list.
Hey, you better back up.
I'm sorry, that
you
is my bad.
Back up here means get back, move away from me. Now the structure, you'd better, is actually you had better. You had better, we contracted to you'd, right? You'd better. This structure, you better do this, you better do that, is usually used when giving a suggestion. For example, oh, you're leaving. Hey, you better take an umbrella because I think it'll rain. But in this context here, you better, or you better back up, for example, is more of a warning or ultimatum. So you can use you better do something as a warning or ultimatum, like we see here, or most of the time to give a suggestion. Here's an example from an old classic movie, I think from the 90s, that I remember, where the guy is using this phrase, you better, but as a warning, as an ultimatum. Here it is.
You better hope I don't make it back. All of you.
All right, learning many cool things so far? I'm sure you are. But now it's time for the ultimate test. Can you watch the scenes again without subtitles and understand 100%? I think you can. Let's see it. Also, there might be some extra questions for you to answer. Here it is.
Manicore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world, who built their own spy network to manipulate world events and amass wealth and power. And with Citadel slaughtered and MindTech in their hands, they wreaked havoc.
To amass means to accumulate, to dismiss, to extract.
Manicore was founded by 8 of the wealthiest families from around the world, who built their own spy network to manipulate world events and amass wealth and power. And with Citadel slaughtered and MindTech in their hands, they wreaked havoc. Oil crises, grid failures, catastrophic wars.
You didn't bring us here to keep us safe.
I brought you here because I very much need your help. Mason's help. Early this morning, Citadel's X case containing all our secrets was stolen by 2 Manticore agents. The kind of secrets that could murder millions of people or hold entire nations hostage.
Filling the blanks to form a sentence that means to cause great damage. wreak havoc.
Bernard Orlick. Manticore. The X case. Any of that ring a bell?
You really need to get out of my way, buddy.
They wiped your memories. I was on a train 8 years ago in Italy. There was an explosion. I was pulled from the water. I couldn't remember who I was or how I got there. You were on that train with me.
No.
You were a spy, like me, for an organization called Citadel.
I don't know what you're on, but I'm gonna walk past you through that door, and if you touch me, I'm gonna scream, okay?
Catch.
Did you just throw a knife at me?
I thought you were gonna catch it. See, Bernard did it to me, and I thought you were gonna catch it, and then I was gonna be like, Ben, how come you can do that?
Hey, you better back up.
I'm sorry, that
you
is my bad.
Up.
I am backing up.
That's not backing up.
I'm backed
up. Back up!
Nadia Fink.
A synonym for wipe is record, eliminate, hack. All right, now it's time for the comment of the day. And the comment of the day comes from The Lesson Suits, which we published recently here on the channel. The comment goes, Thiago, your English tutoring skills are as sharp and cunning as Harvey Specter's legal maneuvers, ensuring that we all speak with the eloquence and confidence of a true closer in the language realm. That's an awesome comment. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And very nice vocabulary here. So I actually have a challenge for you guys. You see that in the comment, we have the words sharp and cunning. Here's the challenge. Look up the meaning of these words, sharp, cunning, and then create one sentence with each one and post your sentences here in the comment section below so I can see them. All right, I'm curious to see what you come up with. Guys, great job, you rock, you've made it until the end of the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who's also learning English, and subscribe to the channel in case you are not subscribed yet. And if you wanna keep learning English while having a ton of fun, you really wanna check out this next lesson. Here it is.
But if you fire me, then I could tell them that you lied about me and you definitely lose your license.
Are you telling me that if I throw you under the bus, you're gonna drag me with you?
But you put your interests above mine, and I'm just putting mine back up next to yours.
You're rehired.